They say 5G is going to completely change our lives, from as simple as gaming to driving to as complex as medical care. This shift will be a once-in-a-decade upgrade for our wireless systems. Now, that all sounds great, but what is it, and when can I get it? Well, there's a brand new second-generation cellular module from the current leading chip company, Qualcomm, that boasts the almighty power of 5G speeds for your phone. Except, we all don't exactly have 5G phones yet, nor a 5G mobile network. However, this might be the year all of that changes. If you're just being brought up to speed, 5G is known as the fifth generation of wireless network communication. Every time the technical rules that define the inner workings of cellular networks changes, we get a new generation, or G, of technology. Meaning to reap the benefits, people will have to buy whole new phones, and carriers will need to install new transmission equipment to deliver the speeds they promised. When we got 1G, it was for voice calls only. But then 2G gave us text messages. 3G added that multimedia support that we can't imagine being without, like vid chats and faster speeds. And now we have 4G, which has all the features of 3G, but an added bump of speeds from 14 megabits per second to 100 megabits per second, which changed the game. Now we have video chats in HD, HD mobile TV, and live streamed apps. But this next one is gonna be big. 5G is anticipated to give users the fastest connectivity they've ever experienced. It's thought to be so fast, it'd compete with our current fiber optic cables we have in our homes, and about 10 to 100 times faster than the phone you currently have in your hand. But other than the major benefits of downloading 8K videos in seconds and using VR and AR seamlessly, goodbye buffering, why does the world want data coming in so fast? Well, 5G connectivity promises reduced latency, or lag time, to practically zero, meaning devices can communicate with each other in nearly real time. We're talking about major improvements in the responsiveness in devices that use sensors to make important decisions, like self-driving cars that need to suddenly brake, or industrial robots that can be sent to hazardous areas and be controlled remotely from anywhere in the world, or better yet, anything in the healthcare field. From telemedicine, precision surgical robots, to remote surgery, or even virtual physical therapy sessions. All of this without any data slowdown. But wait, how does any of this work? Well, 5G systems will run on smaller, what they call cell sites, that divide their territory into different sections. Then, exchanges between cell sites and devices are made with encoded data through radio waves, called OFDM. This encoding isn't much different from what 4G LTE uses, but the frequencies they use within the spectrum are. Right now, the low-band spectrum that 4G LTE travels on is overly crowded, and therefore, we can expect speeds up to 2 gigabytes per second. Which, by the way, doesn't seem too bad running on Verizon Visible for only $40 a month, but we can get to that more later on. 5G can currently travel on a couple kinds of airwaves. One low-band frequency and one high frequency. The plans are for low-band frequency 5G to operate through 4G cell sites that companies already have in place. But the encoding will be more flexible and use a bigger channel size to get up to 50% better speeds than LTE. This isn't too bad. But since we want that multi-gigabit ultra-fast speeds, we're going to use higher frequencies on the millimeter wave spectrum. Now, it slightly varies, but millimeter waves are signals estimated to be above 24 gigahertz or 30 gigahertz, where there's enough spectrum available to create big channels for very high speeds. But what researchers have been struggling with is the fact that these wavelengths are easily blocked and can only go very short distances. So a new infrastructure is needed. That's why we have to get the small cell sites. Hundreds, if not thousands, of low power base stations outputting only 2 to 10 watts each will have to be built in and around city homes to keep the connectivity in place. There are select places around the US that actually already have some of them, but we still need our devices to upgrade to get the speeds we want. This is where the Qualcomm chip comes in. Qualcomm is a wireless chip maker, and they've been at the forefront of advancements in chip technology since the 3G era. Their new one, creatively called Snapdragon X55 5G, is a modem that would run along their new millimeter wave antenna, the QTM525. The idea is that these modules will help smartphones connect to the new and improved network of 5G, as well as stay connected to the previous Gs 2 through 4. They anticipate that phone makers will embed 3 or 4 modules in their devices, so the device always gets a signal from one module, even if the others are blocked by something like your hand. And Qualcomm is not the only one. There are other brands that are in the works to make 5G happen for the consumer market. So for us to really reap the benefits of this all-powerful 5G speed, the whole infrastructure needs to change. You can't have the 5G phone without the 5G network. And you can't have the 5G network until you get the mini cell towers. But companies are making massive strides. Most of the phones and networks are planning to launch at the end of 2019. So keep your eyes peeled and your phones ready to throw out. And while you're waiting for 5G, why not check out Visible? Visible is the new way to think about phone service. No stores, no annual contracts, no hidden fees. Just 40 bucks a month for unlimited messages, minutes, and data, all on Verizon's network. When you think the future of phone service, think Visible. So what do you think? Is 5G worth all the hype? Let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe. And if you like this video, check out this one about China's plan to build a transcontinental grid. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time on Seeker.